All right, section six. FRA Railroad Administration Office of Railroad Safety, Department of Transportation, United States of America, Track Inspector, Rail Defect Inspector, Reference Manual, July 2015, Revision 2. Section 6, FRA Remedial Action Guidance. The Rail Defect Remedial Action Guidance is designated with the Track Safety Standards in Title 49 Code Federal Regulations, Part 213, Section 213.113, Defect of Rails. Notes, assigned a person designated with the 213.7 statute supervise each of the operation over the defect of rail. A2, assign the person designated under the title statute 213.7 to make a visual inspection. After the visual inspection, that person may authorize operation to continue without continuous visual supervision at a maximum of 10 miles per hour for up to 24 hours prior to each of the visual inspection, replacement, or the repair of the rail. B. Limit the operation speed over the defective rail to the authorized person with the designated under the statute 213.7A who has at least 1 year supervisor experience for the railroad track and maintenance. The operating speed cannot be over 30 miles an hour. Maximum allowable speed of 213.9 of the class of the track considered, whichever is lower. C. The apply the joint bars bolted and only through the outermost hole of the defect within 10 days after the determined to continue with the track in use. In the case of class 3 through 5 track, limiting the operating speed of the defective rail for the 30 miles an hour until the joint bars are applied. Therefore, after the limited speed to 50 miles per hour, the maximum allowable speed of the title in statute 213.9 for the class track is concerned. Whichever is lower, whenever the search of the internal rail defects is conducted with the statute 213.237, the defect is discovered in class 3 and through 5, that the required remedial action C, the operation speed should be limited to 50 miles per hour, maximum allowable speed of the title statute 213.9 for the class of track concerned, whichever is lower, for the period of not exceeding 4 days if the defective rail has not been removed from the track or permanent repair made within 4 days of the discovery. Limiting operating speed of the defective rail is to 30 miles per hour until the joint bars are, and thereafter limited speed of 50 miles per hour, the maximum allowable speed under 213.9 of the class track of the concern, whichever is lower, with the joint bars have not been applied with the 10 days, but the speed must be limited to 10 miles per hour until the joint bars are applied. D. Apply joint bars bolted with only through the outermost hole defective within 7 days after the determined continued the track in use. In the case of class 3 and through 5 track, limiting operation speed of the defective rail 30 miles per hour, less authorized by the person designated under 213.7A who has at least 1 year of supervisor experience with the railroad track maintenance until the joint bars are applied. Thereafter, limited speed of the 50 miles per hour, maximum allowable speed under 213, statute 213.9 for the class of the track concerned, which ever is lower, when the joint bars have then not been applied within 7 days, the speed must not be limited to, speed must be limited to 10 miles an hour until the joint bars are applied. E. The applying joint bars is defective bolt in accordance with the statute 213.121 D and E. Inspect the rail 90 days after the determined continuing of the track in use. The rail remains the track, replaced with repair of the re-inspection. The cycle start over each successive re-inspection unless the re-inspection reveals the rail defect increased with the size. Therefore, before the defective more restrictive remedial action, the process continues identifying until the rail removed from the track repaired. If it is not inspected with 90 days limited speed for the class 2 tracks, maximum allowable speed under statute 213.9 with the class track concern, which is lower, until it is inspected. G. Inspect the rail 30 days after the determined to continue with the track in use. The rail remains in the track, is not replaced or repaired. A reinspection cycle restarted over the successive inspection unless the reinspection reveals that the rail defect has to have increased to the size, therefore the subject to more restrictive remedial action. The process continues indefinitely until the rail was removed from the track or the repaired. If it is not inspected but 30 days limited to speed for the class 2 operation, maximum allowable speed under statute 213.9 for the class track concern, whichever is lower, until it is inspected. H. Limiting operating speed over the defective rail for 50 miles an hour, maximum allowable speed under the statute 213.9 for the class of the track concern, which is lower. I. Limiting operating speed of defective rail to 30 miles an hour with the maximum allowable speed of 213.9 for the class of track concern, whichever is lower. All right, moving on to guidance in this paragraph. A, the FRA explains that the only person qualified under the statute 213.7 is a designated qualified qualified person to supervise certain renewals and inspection track, is able to determine that the track may continue to be used in a defective condition and is identified with the rail. The operation is repaired and added to the paragraph to allow railroads to use recent developing process to remove the defective portion of the rail section, normally to remove the transverse defects and defective welds, replace the portion of the rail section using recent developed welded technologies commonly referred to as slot welds or wide gap welds. These processes allow the remaining portion of the non-defective rail to remain the track. The FRA designated from the former paragraph B as in, used in the section as paragraph D added to the new paragraph B. The paragraph B provides that the track owner have only 4-hour period in which the certain suspected defects exist in the rail section. Once they learn that the rail indicates any of the defects identified in paragraph C, the remedial action is for this 4-hour deferred verification period only is suspected defects that may be required remedial action. Note C through I found in remedial action table. This 4-hour period does not apply with the suspected defects that may require remedial action. Note that A or A2 or B, which are more serious, must continue the verified immediately. The 4-hour time frame provides flexibility to allow the rail flaw and detector car to continue the testing of the non-stop in the mode without requiring verification of less serious unsuspected defects that require the remedial actions under note C through I. The flexibility also provides help to avoid need to operate the detector car and not test run light mode over the possibility severe defect rail conditions that cause a derailment. Whenever they're having to clear track them in traffic movement. However, any suspected defective encountered that may require remedial action, note A2B requires immediate verification. Overall, 4-hour deferred verification period is intended to help improve the rail flaw detector. Can usage allow for the operation of the chase of the car inspection method of the operation, increasing the opportunity to detect more serious defects, ensuring the entire of the rail detector intended for the travel over the wheel is serious service inspected. The operation of the repair is added to the paragraph B. One of the clarification is stated with the paragraph A. FRA adding to the new paragraph C to contain both of the remedial action table and it's noted revised formally. We were included under the paragraph A is in the paragraph D. There are 3 rail defects are redefined as compound fissure, defective weld, and flattened rail. And one is headed with the crush wet, and all rail flaw definitions are enumerated with alphabetical order. The remedial actions required of the defective rails specifically definite time limits and speed. Remedial actions also allow certain discretion of the track owner to continue operation over the certain defects. Inspectors should consider all rail defects dangerous in cars. Care and should be taken to determine the properly remedial actions that have been accomplished with the track owner of the railroad. Whenever the more one defect that is present at the rail, the defective route requiring with the most restrictive remedial action must be governed. Note that this technical bull is an FRA use of the track owner of the railroad intended with the interchangeable bull where the railroad is the track owner, otherwise assigned responsibility in accordance with the statute 213.5. The remedial action table of the specification is the rule address for the risk associated with the rail failure. The risk is primarily depending upon the defective size and should not be dependent upon the manner and mechanism of the rail's existence of the defect. The failure of the track owner to comply with the operational speed, the restriction maintenance procedures prescribed, inspection intervals specified with the section 213.20, statute 213.237, defective rails, inspection of the rail respectively may result in violation of track safety standards TSS. Specifically, FRA revised the remedial action as follows. Transverse defects, FRA placed at the transverse fissure defective is some of the same category, defail fracture, engine burn fracture, defective weld because they all normally fail in the transverse plane. Compound fissure remains the same remedial action classification. The type of the defects is increased potentially to fail the oblique plane and consider the more serious defect. FRA changed for the heading of the remedial action table to the all transverse type. Transverse type of defects, compound fissure, transverse fissure, detail fissure, engine burn fracture, defective welds, to refer to as a percentage of the existing railhead of the cross-section area, weakened and defective. indicating all transverse defects which are relating to the actual railhead cross-section area. Additional repair is added to the heading of the table. FRA reduces the cross-section area of the railhead, which requires remedial action, notes A2, E, and H, to 60% of the prior limited to 80%. FRA added required remedial action definition of the longitudinal defect associated with the defect of weld longitudinal. FRA added crush head to the remedial action table of defective definition. Footnote number one reminds the inspector that the chip rail ends the designated rail defect under the section is not in itself the FRA enforceable defective condition. Inspectors are reminded that a chip rail end is not the considered a breakout in the rail head. Footnote two provides that the remedial action note D applies to the moon-shaped breakout resulting in the derailment with length of greater than 6 inches, not exceeding 12 inches, width not exceeding one-third of the rail base width. The FRA recommends the track owners conduct a special visual inspection rail pursuant to 213-239 before pursuing operations of any of the train over the affected track. A special visual inspection pursuant to Statute 213-239, which requires the inspection to be made track involved derailment incident, should be done to assess the condition of the track associated with the broken conditions before the operation of any of the train over the affected area. Note A clarifies that the person qualified to supervise certain renewals inspection track designated in Statute 213-7 must visualize supervise each operation over the defective rail. A2 addresses mid-range transverse defects. The remedial action allows the train to operation continue to maximum 10 miles an hour up to 24 hours following the visual inspection by a person designated under Statute 213-7. If the rail is not repaired and replaced, another 24-hour cycle begins. Note B. Limits and speed authorize a person designated under Statute 213-7A who has at least 1 year supervising experience in the track maintenance qualified person. The responsibility to evaluate the rail defect authorize the maximum over operating speed over the defective rail based on the side of the defective operation condition. However, the maximum speed over the rail may not exceed 30 miles an hour. Maximum speed of Statute 213-9 of the class of tracking concern whichever is lower. Note C, D, and H limited the operating speed following the application of the joint bars 50 miles an hour maximum allowable speed under Statute 213-9 for the class of the track considered whichever is lower. The maximum speed is specified in Note C, B, C, D, and H exceeds the current track speed rail is required to record the defect. For example, the rail determined with the remedial action. Note B is required at the track speed already 30 miles an hour or less. Railroad must record the defect that indicates the railroad is aware of the characteristics of the defective rail and designated permissible speed in compliance with the regulation. Note C applies to specifically detailed fractures, engine burn fractures, transverse fissures, defective welds, address defects that are discussed during the internal rail inspection required under Statute 213-237, whose size determined is not to excess of 25% of the railhead cross-sectional area. For specific defects, the track owner formerly had to apply joint bars and bolt in only through the outermost and the defective location the 20 days after the determining the continuing of the tracks in use. Note C, if revised other specific detail defective not requires track owner to apply joint bar only through the outermost hole to the defect for the 10 days determined of the continuing the track use. When the joint bars have not been applied within 10 days, the track speed must be applied limited to 10 miles per hour until the joint bars are applied. The additional allows the railroad alternative relief remedial action the type of the defects class 1 and class 2 track. Note D, applies specifically detailed fracture, engine burn fracture, transverse fissure, defective failures, address the defects discovered during the internal rail inspection required under Statute 213-237, whose size determines not in the excess of 60% of the railhead cross-sectional area. Formally specific details that the track owner had at the point apply the joint bars bolted through the outermost of the defective location in the 10 days after the determination of the track should be continued. Note D, it is revised that specific detail defects are not required for the requires the track owner to apply the joint bars bolted to the outermost bar hold the defect 7 days and determining the continuing the track and use. The allowance of 7 days provides the track owner with additional time to remediation the defective identified with just prior to the start of the weekend shutdown. When the joint bars have not been applied within 10 days, the track speed must be limited to 10 miles per hour until the joint bars are applied, and it's mentioned in Note C. In the addition, also the railroad's alternative relief and remedial action the type of the defects class 1 and 2 track. When an FRA inspector discovered the defective rail, they required the railroad representative to determine which to continue the track and use the designated the maximum speed over the rail. The inspector should inquire the representative's knowledge of the defect, remedial action if the railroad was not aware of the defect prior to the FRA's inspection. The FRA inspector should observe the section, reserve the actions by the railroad representative to determine compliance. If the railroad previously found with the defective rail, the FRA should conform with the proper remedial action was taken during the railroad inspection. The FRA inspector should confirm that the defects were recorded and properly remedial action was taken. The remedial action table: the defects failing the transverse planes, transverse compound fissure, detailed the engine burn fractures, defective well, specifically lower limit range bases of 5% of the railhead cross-sectional area, the transverse condition is reported less than 5% of the track, owner not legibly bound to provide currently under the TSS conditions reported to be less than 5% of the not consistent with during the rail braking routines. Therefore, the defective determination within its range is not always reliable. Compound fissure conditions weakened between 5% and 70% of the cross-sectional area of the railhead. Defects from required the remedial action. Note B. Defects range of 70% to less than 100% of the cross-sectional area required the action. Note A to as prescribed. Defects 100% of the cross-sectional area head requiring remedial action. Note A prescribed that the most respective remedial action inspector should be aware of the compound fissure defects of the failed transverse oblique planes and characteristics of the rail that has not been controlled or cooled normally roller plane prior to the 1936. Defects identified with the group, the detailed fracture, engine burn fracture, the transverse defect wells will weaken and will normally fall in the transverse plane. The defective fractures characteristics of the controlled cooled rail usually indicates the letters CC and CH of the rail brand, i.e. 1360 RECC CFNI 1982, fourth month of April. This prescribed remedial action relates to the long range between 5 and 25%, mid-range 25 to 60%. Note that C&D respectfully these defects of joint bar applications, operational speed restrictions within certain time of the frame, defective extending the less than 100%, more than 60%, requiring the visual inspection. If the rail is not replaced, effectively repaired, or removed from the service, the effect of the elective would be restricting the operation to the maximum 10 miles per hour up through 24 hours before then performing a visual inspection. The second sentence is remedial action note number C, the address of the defects discovered in class 3 through 3 through 5 during the internal real inspection under the section statute 213-237, which was determined not to be in excess of 25% of the rail across the area section area. For the specific defects, the track owner may operate for a period of not exceeding 4 days, speed limited to 50 miles an hour, maximum allowable speed under the title of Statute 213-9 for the class of the track considered, whichever is lower, the defective rail is removed from the permanent rail, is not made within 4 days of the discovery. The speed limit is 30 miles an hour until the joint bars are applied and replaced. The requirements specified in the second paragraph are intended to promote the better usage of the rail inspection equipment, therefore maximizing the opportunity to discover the rail defects which are approachingly serious of the failure size. The result of the FRA, which results in identification of the defects of the type, the size, the range of the periodic predictable slow growth life, the result further indicates that even one of the today's most heavily used trackage in the today defects of the type, size, the uncommonly to grow in the surface of the fissure, failure to size detail. In this remedial action, a longitude defects combined with one of the groups that show that the identical remedial action take actions based on the reported size of the type of the longitudinal defects are also share the similar growth rates and same radial actions as appropriate each type. Defective rails categorized by horizontal split head, vertical split head, split web, pipe rail, head web separation, defective well, or longitudinal in a longitudinal nature with any of the new growth defects is more than 1 inch but not more than 2 inches. The remedial initiated under note H is to limit the speed to 50 miles per hour. No F requires the reinspection of the rail in 90 days and deciding the operation will continue if not inspected within 90 days. Limited speed for the Class 2 track, maximum allowable speed of Statute 213-9 for the Class track and is considered whichever is lower until the inspected. Defective range for more than 2 inches, not more than 4 inches, requiring they comply with the OING speed limits of 30 miles an hour and reinspected within 30 days. If they decide, operations will continue if not inspected within 30 days. The speed limit is focus in Class 2 track maximum allowable speed and is unattached to 213.9 for the class track speed concern, whichever is lower until the speed is infected. Where any of the six defects type exceed length of 4 inches, a person may designate it under statute 213.7A, must limit the operating speed to 30 miles an hour, note B. Another form of headwind separation, other referred to as the fillet crack rail, is the longitudinal growth of the crack of the fillet area. They usually grow on the gauge side of the outer rail of the curve of the crack and may not exceed the full width of the head of the web, and the potential dangerous of evidence of the fillet cracking, the hairline cracking running beneath the head of the rail, the bleeding and rust discolorization. Fillet crack often results in proper slope elevation other than stress reversal, resulting in tramposing the rail. The use of the miner is an effect in the aid examining the rail and determining head web cracks and separating the body of the rail. A bolt hole crack is a progressive fracture originating with the bolt hole extending away from the bolt hole, usually at an angle, develops a high stress riser, usually initiating a result of both dynamic thermal in response with the joint and the bolt points out of the edge of the hole under the load. A major cause of the high stress improper field drilling of the hole, excessive longitudinal rail movement, and can also have high stress along with the edge of the hole when evaluating in the rail end, which has multiple hole bolt hole cracks. Inspectors will determine the required remedial action based on the length of the longest individual bolt hole crack. Under NHF, the remedial action of the bolt hole crack is more than one half of the bolt, one half of the inch is not more than 1 inch of the rail, is replaced with the limited speed of 50 miles an hour maximum allowable under statute 213.9 for the class of track concerned. Then the reinspecting and rail in 90 days. If the operation continues for the bolt hole cracks greater than 1 inch, not exceeding the 1 1/2 inches, note the H and G apply. These rails are required to limit it to 50 miles an hour reinspecting within 30 days. The bolt hole crack exceeding 1 1/2 inches, person qualified under statute 213.7 may elect to designate a speed restriction which cannot extend 30 miles an hour of the maximum allowable statute 213.9 for the class track concerned, whichever is lower. Under notes F and G, where the corrective actions require the rail review, inspect the specific number of the rail, number of days, discover the several options of compliance may be experienced, exercise or dependent with the nature of the defect, for the those defective and strictly internal that are not very visibly naked to the eye, the only option would be to perform an inspection with the rail flaw detection equipment, either the rail mounted or handheld. The defectives are visually and naked eye, therefore the measurable visual inspection and inspection with the rail flaw detection equipment is an acceptable option, and for the certain defectives enclosed with the joint bar area, such as bolt holes, cracks, and head web separation, the joint bars will be removed visually. Reinspection is made. The reinspection prescribed in note F and G must be performed prior to the expiration of 30 to 90 day intervals. If the rail remains and the track is not replaced and repaired, reinspection starts over the successful reinspection unless the reinspection reveals that the rail defect increased in size and has become some or two of most restrictive remedial action. Consequence of the process continues identifying until the rail is removed from the track or repaired. When the corrective action requires the rail to be reinspected within a specific number of the days and discover the track owner of the excessive exercise several options of the compliance, one option would be to perform another inspection with the rail flag detection equipment, either the rail mounted or handheld. Any other option would perform the visual inspection with the defect visible, measurable lateral case, and the certain defects have been closed with the joint area and the bolt hole breaks. Removal of the joint bars necessary to comply with the reinspection requirements. If not inspected with a 30 to 90 day timeline, limited speed to class 2 track, the maximum allowable speed under the title statute 213.9 for the class track and its concern, whichever is lower, until it is inspected. The change that defines the reinspection cycle requires the track owner to comply, continue with the reinspection, or apply the reduction in speed. If the defects in the track beyond the reinspection interval, railroad must continue to monitor the defects to the appropriate actions required of the remedial action table. A broken base can result in an improper bearing of the base of the track at the spot, track spiking or tie plate shoulder from over-crimped anchors, or may originate with a manufacturing flaw. With today, axle load inspectors can anticipate the broken base defect in 75-pound smaller rail sections, irregular track surfaces, especially in field side, and for any broken base discovered is more than 1 inch or but less than 6 inches in length. Remedial action, note D, to apply the joint bars bowl through the outermost holes with the defective within 10 days. If the operations continue in class 3 to 5, the operation must be reduced to 30 miles an hour or less, authorized by a person under statute 213.7a, until the joint bars are applied. After the operating speed is limited to 50 miles per hour maximum allowable under the statute 213.9 with class track concern, whichever is lower. Under note D, there are several acceptable outermost bolt hole arrangements, joint bars, centered rail defects, see figure 1, illustrating accepting the bolt hole arrangements. In all cases, railroads may not drill a bolt hole next to a defect infected that is being remediated, applicating joints bars pursuant to D. This reason is not for drilling next to the defect, is to prevent propagation of the crack through the hole close to the defect. Figure 47 shows illustrates acceptable bolt or hole arrangements. Basically, from their outside, and so the cracks don't go any bigger. A broken basin is all right. Broken base in excess of 6 inches requires an assignment of the person designated in Title Statute 213.7. Visual supervise each of the train operations over the defective rail. The railroad may apply the joint bars defective bolt only in accordance with the Statute 213.121 D and E. Therefore, must limit the train's operation to 30 miles an hour maximum allowed under the Statute 213.9 for the class of the track concerned, whichever is lower. Reference the dimensions between the outermost holes of the 24-inch joint, but vary between the approximately 15 and 18 inches from for 36-inch joint bars approaches 30 inches. Inspector should point out that the track owner of the broken base is near the dimension may negotiate the purpose for which the joint bars are applied. The broken base of the may caused by the damage to the external source of the rail anchors to be driven with the base of the derailed wheel. And improper consideration damage rail is defective, address some more stringent provision of applicable broken bases, and note that the A and E and I damage rail car may result from the flat of the broken incidental hammer blows derailed dragging equipment, reducing the operational speed of this class 3 and 5 the tracks at 30 miles an hour, joint bars applied, and lessen the impact of the force imparted to the broken area. Applying the joint bars under the note D ensures the proper horizontal vertical line rail alignment in the event of the rail failure. Flattened rails, crush heads, and the localized collapse at the head is also caused by the mechanical interaction with the receptive let where wheel loadings. FRA industry reaches indicate that the occurrence of the most accurate categorized rail surface conditions, not rail defects, as they do not in themselves cause severe failure and failure of the rail, although no condition is in the effect of the structural integrity of the rail section, and it can result in less than desirable dynamic wheel vehicle response, higher speed ranges of the flattened rail conditions identified within the table, as well as defined in portion 213.113b, being 3/8 of an inch of an inch more in depth below the rest of the rail head and 1/8 inch of an inch more in length. As the defective becomes more severe, the reduced rail head depth when the wheel increases, the rule addresses the flattened rail in terms of the specified rail remedial action for the certain depth of length of the location meeting the depth and length of the criteria must be limited to operating the speed of 50 miles per hour, the maximum allowable under statute 213.9, and for the class of the track concerned, whichever is lower. Breakout in the rail head is defined as a piece of physically separated with the parent rail and the rail defects meeting of the definition is required to have each of the operating defective rail visually supervised as a person designated under statute 213.7. Inspectors needed to be unaware of the definition applicable across the wide range of rail defects as indicated with the remedial action table. When the rail defects have not been proposed, progress to the point which they have definition of breakout or due to the type of the length and location of the defects and present of the hazards, continue with the train operation. Inspector should determine the remedial action if in any of the track owners should be institution. Should institute the following are two railhead breakout examples where no A corrective action would be necessary. Example 1, a bolt hole breakout with the head of the rail is totally separated from the parent of the rail, either tight or loose bolt. The pieces of the rail will physically lift off the joint of the bars of the hand. The inspector may determine the separation with the total separated piece rattled with the tape and the information railroad with the appropriate remedial action at this situation. It is potentially very unsafe and impossible known to will happen to the next train operating with a defect of the train could cause the piece of the to because become so loose that it comes out of place and cuts out and cocks out at an angle and causes the wheel to ramp off and derail the train. Example 2, a vertical split with the head of the defect rail with the rear railhead separation apparent because of the inspector can determine the physical separation has occurred with the railhead. The railhead is not entirely separated with the entire length of the defect. Following the example of the note no A, the corrective action would be necessary. Example, the at the rail joints at a chip rail end, which is not considered a rail defect according to the current statute table 213.133. Should not be considered with the breakout of the railhead. The issue of the excessive railway continues. The evaluated rail integrity task force, the FRA, believes the insufficient data existing at the time indicates that the parameters of the conditions should be proposed in a minimum standard. Some railroads apply the welds to strap the thermite to the type of the field bud. The strap does not provide the same support of the joint bar. They would provide only with the limited support of the welding area to break under the train movement, such as does not comply with the provision of corrective action C and D and E, installation of the joints, only the joint bar having full contact with the bottom of the rail. Head and base, statute 213.121A, and when the manufacturer relief of the welding material would be complied with the correction of action C, D, and E. When the FRA inspector with the rail defect appears in the originate with the fatigue of the bond wire attachment weld, the inspector should cite the railway using the part 213 defective code of the 011-3B. Inspectors must also identify the narrative type of the rail defect, the defective weld, detailed fracture. The FRA added the defective path based on the National Transportation Safety Board, a recommendation arising from the National Transportation Safety Board investigation on February 9, 2003. The Canadian National Railway derailment in Tomorrow, Illinois, the National Train Safety Board determined that the probable cause of the accident was that the Canadian National placement of the bond wire welds on the head of the rail outside of the joint bar were untempered martensite associated with the welds led to fatigue cracking that because of the increased stress associated within the known soft ballast rapidly progressed in the rail failure. FRA provides the track inspector rail defect reference manual on the e-library on the website. Inspectors expected to converse conversant of the rail defective type, the appearance, growth, hazards, and method of detection. Section 7, flaw detection.